Good morning, I'm Steve Wallis from Gilpin Demolition. I'm the site manager for running this site at Deer Park Inn. This property is due for demolition. We've started on site yesterday morning, setting up our perimeter fencing to make sure the site is secure and to keep all the public safe. Welfare has been set up. Early investigation on site, we were due to start asbestos removal inside the building today, but due to the fact that we found that the mains electricity is still live, we are waiting currently for an electrician to turn up on site to basically allow the guys to safely work and remove the asbestos ceilings that are within the building without the potential to cut for any live wires. Obviously at a later date, Western Power will have been arranged to come and cut the mains cable, therefore removing the electric from site. During the obviously operation of the asbestos removal, we will do a good tidy up around the outside. All the signage is going to go up on the fencing. All the locals will send out a letter drop just to let them know of our intention, start dates and working times, and people to call an emergency. I envisage that hopefully that we get the electric cut off this week, we get the asbestos guys working, and then we can move on to bring in one of our 20 ton excavators with a demolition sorting grab, and it'll be able to take the building apart in an audible sequence. In demolition nowadays, it's all down to recycling and cutting costs and putting everything into the appropriate categories of waste materials. So really about nearly 99% of our waste is sorted, whereas we don't like to send anything towards landfill anymore because all these landfills are shut in. We basically would sit a machine there. We're going to start on the front conservatory. It's like a little hand grab if you envisage it on the end of the machine, and it will gradually, the operator will pick pieces off the building, sort them down at ground level and put them in the appropriate piles. The then stage will move into the flat roof area and take the flat roof off the front of the building. At this stage we will stop. We have to remove the asbestos containing roof tiles from the building. Now this is going to be done by hand from a moot boom, which are like sort of cherry pickers that guys work from. The slates will be bagged up and then brought down and put into a hazardous waste skip to then be taken off to a facility then for them to be buried in. Obviously once all asbestos material is then roofed from that section of the building, demolition can continue and that will be repeated all the way through the building to the rear end of the site. Once we get to the rear end of the site, hopefully everything will be down to ground level, slabs will be cleared off, footings will be removed, and the swimming pool is also due to be removed. Within all of this, obviously we've got to take care to the neighbours and the boundary walls that obviously neighbour the property that are due to stay up. And obviously giving you guys as developers a nice clean brown site for you guys to work on and start your build off. Obviously, we have asbestos surveys that are done beforehand, which a surveyor will go around and try and identify all asbestos containing material. It's not always possible to ascertain all those materials. Sometimes on other jobs we have come across materials that haven't been discovered within the survey because they're within the fabric of the building that wasn't discovered. Maybe contamination under the ground, but fingers crossed on this job we won't have any of that, but we've always got to allow in a job that we may have small delays. If it's only small, then obviously that can probably be dealt with within the time scale, but obviously a mass sort of investigation or discovery that could potentially delay the job, but small ones we're normally able to deal with and cope with. So